So if you are here today, you are here by divine appointment. And you did not come by chance. As many people as are ready for the breakthrough power of God to begin to work for them now. I want you to pray this prayer with merciless violence. And pray with boiling anger. Say, oh God, arise!
Lord,
can you say that loud again? Is that the loudest you can say it? I'll let my star shine. In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and begin to pray. That's why Jesus brought you here. Open your mouth and pray like that. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
Let the power of God begin to move from person to person.
Aha.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Say, oh God of perfection.
Oh Lord,
perfect everything concerning my life. In the name of Jesus, perfect everything concerning my life. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Silence, beloved. The power of God is trying to move in our midst here. There are people here now. The enemy is silently tormenting you and eating away your body. But either way, you are the power of God is coming upon you. And the yoke of that vampire power is broken completely. That's right.
Then,
that evil ringing inside the ears has been completely silenced now. So this month, Lord, you hear the word of the Lord. He wants you to bear Olua. Arise, delay, and favor me.
Cause it shall be
in the name of Jesus. Prophesy to the month. Prophesy to the month. That's right,
Benny. And Christ. In the name of Jesus. Hear the word of the Lord. Arise up. In the name of Jesus, this month. Hear the word of the Lord. Arise up.
Masikaya Boschenera Bokoma, the Russo Tony Bakin, the Kessenten, the Bokoma, in Jesus' name we pray.
Lord of Jesus, La Badura.
Father, we thank you for a time like this. And we praise your holy name for bringing us here. We thank you for protection. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your loving kindness. Thank you for your power, which is excellent. We thank you for your power, which is absolute power. Accept our gifts in Jesus' name. We're gathered at this special service. Meet everyone gathered there at the point of their needs. As many people as are here today, you will walk away from here with miracles. You will walk from there with testimonies. By the time you leave this place, those who saw you coming in, when they saw you coming out, you will declare that you have seen the glory of God. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In louder, amen. Let's have a seat. God bless you. This morning, before we go away from here,
no, bro, you can't go there.
We have a serious spiritual battle to fight.
A new gun to me, to the Congo Latiga.
I will explain it to you in a very brief manner.
Ni oro ti o po, mo shalaye re fun yin.
Then we begin to pray.
I will bear si gbadura.
For a few minutes.
Fun seju die.
I want to discuss what I call power against graveyard spirits.
Professor Olori agbara lodisi awon emi ipo
power against graveyard spirits.
Agbara lodisi awon emi ipo.
You understand me very soon if you don't understand that.
Bi yo ba ye yi laipe yi o to ye ni.
Now in Psalm 31.
Le ori David ikokan le ni okan.
Verse 17. Psalm 31 verse 17.
Ori David ikokan le ni okan. Ese iketadini ogun.
He's saying something very interesting.
Oso okan to la ni.
Psalm 31 17.
Ori David ikokan le ni okan.
He says, let me not be ashamed. Oh Lord, for I call upon thee. Let the wicked be ashamed. And let them be silent in the grave. There is an entity, a spiritual entity, a location known as the grave. In the same Psalm 49, Psalm 49, verse 15. Psalm 49, 15. Look at what it says. Say, but God will redeem my soul from the power of the grave. For he shall receive. So the grave has some powers.
It's a only our.
The psalmist was still alive when he was saying this one.
Only Sam Boguti, look at
and he wasn't about to die yet.
It was yet,
but he said, God will redeem my soul from the power of the grave.
But we be alone in your coming, love is our.
The power of the grave.
Agbara is a ogun.
Because of this power of the grave, when Jesus died,
nitori agbara is a ogun nigba ti Jesus Christ ku,
he had to go to that grave.
O lo si is a ogun.
In 1 Peter chapter 3 verse 19.
Peteru kini ori keta ese nkan kan.
Some people were being held in captivity in the grave at that time.
Ade awon kan sinu igbekun ni is a ogun.
Jesus had to go there.
Jesus Christ lati lo sibe
to preach there.
That he was
a deliverance message.
He was to see
in 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 19. 1 Peter 3:19. By which also he went and preached unto the spirits in prison. Jesus went down.
Jesus Christ is up and along
to the grave to preach to the spirits that are held in prison there.
That
is a prison in the grave. And we need to understand that. But look at what it says in 1 Corinthians chapter 15.
1
Corinthians 15, verse 55. 1 Corinthians 15, verse 55.
Some
of us are still looking for it.
I will only know what in fellowship.
If you are there, say praise God.
1
Corinthians 15, 55. Said, O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is Lord. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. From these passages we've read, certain facts can be deduced.
I will go to that later. When
we say graveyard, what do we mean?
But the question of bukini tomorrow.
We mean the cemetery.
And so they might be temple.
The origin of the word cemetery said put to sleep.
The
graveyard is a place for burying the dead.
It's a quote every time saying, oh, pussy.
A final resting place. The grave is a place of decay and worm.
It's a quote a big jera at the
it is a place of darkness.
Oje ebi okuku.
A place of corruption.
Oje ebi dibaje.
A place where men created from the dust mix back into the dust.
Oje ebi tieni ota jala ti inu erupe yo pada jala bobe erupe.
A place of corruption.
Oje ebi baje.
The Bible says there is no device, there is no knowledge, there is no wisdom in the grave. The grave is always a silent place. Because it's a place of death. But
there
is a mystery about the grave that is not clear to modern man. The grave that has spiritual gates. It has some powers in it. This is why evil men are sometimes attracted to it. And when Satanists want to terminate a life, they go to the grave. They begin to call the living through the gates of the dead. And under the cover of that darkness, they do a lot of terrible things. The Satanists consult the graveyard a lot. Sometimes to appease their gods. Sometimes to acquire from these spirits certain information. Sometimes to release afflictions on other people. Sometimes to release evil winds to blow on people and blow strange sicknesses upon them. Sometimes to destroy people's business, people's career, people's health, people's marriage. Wicked men confer with the graveyard spirits to help them in their wicked decisions. They go there to conjure death against people. These are very, very serious issues. We have seen cases where somebody died and members of the family began to see the ghost all over the place. If you get to some graveyard and you find that the grave has been changed, it's because something has gone wrong. Satanists go there to get superior powers. Magical powers. The secure power. They go there to fight their own battles. And it can be a very serious matter. When you are under warfare by graveyard spirits and you are not aware, a lot of horrible things take place in the graveyard that is not yet clear to modern men. Ghosts are spirits of the dead. Dead unbelievers. Because their soul is kept in a special place to judgment. So that's why it's possible for somebody who is a satanist to call them out. But it doesn't happen with Christians. These spirits can return to where they lived. And they carry out a lot of devastation. Unfortunately, in our nation now, men and women are going deeper and deeper into the occult. in order to cause trouble for others. But then the absolute power belongs to the Lord Jesus
Christ.
A lot of these things have mingled with men and have caused trouble. I remember the story of that man went to a party. Picked up a lady and followed the lady to somewhere in
Surulere.
They entered into a room. All the time, this man was asking the lady, "Are you married?" The lady said, "No, not married." So they went into this room, locked up. They wanted to start their immorality. All of a sudden, I was a loud knock on the door. When the man had the knocks, he asked the woman, "Who is knocking?" The woman said, "My husband." He said, "Oh, you told me you're not married." The woman said, "Sorry, it's a soap of tongues." And the man was banging the door. When this man saw the aggression with which the door was being banged,
he
was afraid. He said, "If this man banging the door like this could get entrance, he knew that he was in trouble." She said, "Madam, where can I hide now? Can I hide under the bed?" The woman said, "Yes." So the man went under the bed, but he was still not comfortable because the knock was so aggressive. He said, "Okay, can I jump out of the window and go?" The woman said, "Okay, you can jump." This man jumped out of the window in Surulere. His two legs landed on the ground. He met himself right inside Aton Cemetery in the dark of the night. So he started to use the moonlight to find his way out. When he got to the gates, the guards at the cemetery thought he was a spirit. They too began to rain incantation against him. They were telling him, go back. But he said, "No. I'm a human being, I'm not a spirit." Eventually they went to him. And I said, "Young man, better for way of praying for yourself or something." And from that day, a serious problem started for him. He became completely restless. Always seeing imaginary things. That's what brought him to Mountain of Fire. And the Lord delivered him. Anyone here today that the of the grave after your life, you shall be delivered. When you are being pursued by graveyard spirits, their agenda may not be to kill you, but once they are pursuing you, there are small symptoms by which you may know that you have been pursued. When you begin to dream of the dead, you dream of being flogged. you dream of being pursued by serpents. You began to see coffins. You find yourself being shot. You're getting married to a dead person. Or walking in the graveyard. Or falling into a pit and you cannot get out. Then know for sure that the graveyard spirits are after you. And you must take aggressive action against them. Once you allow them to operate on him, that they are not there to play with you. Once these powers and manifestation that could be serious health problems, the person will be getting confused now. There may be sickness or disease that is resistant to prayers, resistant to medicine, resistant to all kinds of
activities.
It is not when somebody falls down and is not breathing again that is dead. A person can be a living dead. The powers of the grave can kill a business, they can kill a marriage, they can kill anything in a person's hand. And once they are consulting against you, and you do not stop them, they will stop you. Perhaps you are yet this morning, begin to notice unpardonable errors. Begin to smell death. Look at your family, begin to find its chain of untimely death. Begin to find people talking about suicide. Begin to find good things that you want to do dying in your hands. You begin to find that a thread is now surrounding you. Now you begin to find that any small thing you do, get tired very quickly and you don't know why. Find that the enemy is changing what is around you. Today, take a decision. That these powers that operate in the valley of the shadow of death will not get the better of you. So today you pray a corrective prayer, you pray a preventive prayer. And that's why we're here. How do you deal with this kind of powers? The first is to surrender your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. Make God your friend. He is the only one who can deliver. The Bible says, but thanks be to God, who giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. And he says, oh death, where is thy sting? Oh grave, where is thy victory? There used to be a victory assigned to the grave. But when you make Jesus Christ your friend, that victory of death, of the grave, is destabilized and removed. Complete surrender of your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. Number 2 point. If you want to deal with this place, is to repent from every known sin. Any sin in your life gives the devil a foothold to attack you. There is no small sin. Sin is sin. For the enemy to come against you and to succeed, there must be a ladder. There must be a ladder. And the ladder are the sins we get involved in. Repent from every nonsense. The third thing to do is to wage war against those spirits. The Bible says, right from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and the violent ticketed by force.
You must
now go into the camp of the enemy and take your victory by force.
And
as many people as are here today, and they are ready to take it by force, they shall experience the breakthrough power in the name of Jesus. The fourth thing to do is to barricade your life so they don't have access to you anymore. You barricade your life with the blood of
Jesus
so that they have no access to you at all. Even if you've had access in the past, and they've been calling your name from the gate of the grave, you wage war against them today and barricade your life against them. They will not be able to get close to you. When that power is drawing a person, they have no respect for your academic level, they have no respect for your knowledge. They can finish the person off. Some time ago, I had this professor of philosophy, and he came to me. Said,
Dr. Olukoya.
I said, yes, sir. I have some questions for you. I said, what's the question?
He
said, Solomon in the Bible.
Solomon in the Bible.
How many wives does he have? So 700. How about the concubines? 300. So that makes 1,000, isn't it? I say yes, sir. So now,
Doctor Olukoya,
I just want you to pray for me to marry one extra wife. Just one. I do not intend to compete with Solomon. That's one.
I
said, Professor, you can't do that. What happened to your wife? So, well, that woman is no longer fashionable. I want a fashionable
age.
So I said, no, sir, you can't do it. It's wrong. And I cannot pray. He got angry. He got up. Banged my door. And he went away. No problem. We're used to that. And very soon he found this fashionable woman. But a week to the traditional marriage he was planning, this fashionable woman died. They fixed a burial for the following
Saturday.
When professor got to the burial ground, to his amazement, there was a priest there, and the coffin was still open. And the priest said, welcome, professor. Do you know this woman in the coffin? Professor said, yes.
It's
okay. You are supposed to get married today, but she's been buried now. Before I bury her, let me conduct the wedding first. At that level, the professor should have fled. But he waited there. And this priest began to conduct a marriage between the living and the dead.
alaye ati okun.
Say beloved, we are gathered here today.
Ala ati pejo ni
to join this tree, not the matrimony.
That is why our meeting you go need a bonimo.
After doing that,
let me do shebe.
Now close the coffin.
What you go see?
I started the burial ceremony.
What bury see is it who?
After that day,
let me or you know.
Anywhere professor went,
if you go to professor Balo,
will be seeing the woman.
You marry bring.
If he's teaching in class,
over for money class,
woman is sitting on the table.
Open now, you joke with only tapping it.
I'll be shouting, get up, get up,
get up, get up, get it, get it.
And people will say, Prof, what are you talking? Who are you talking to? What is it?
You don't tell them.
See this woman, see this woman. They took him for psychiatric treatment. They gave him the drugs. They drugs only once in the situation. Because man, instead of seeing one woman, they became two. Was then they brought him back again. I now saw him. He told me the story. He said, well, Professor, I warned you. He did it.
Oh my God.
And that's how he got delivered from those powers. I pray that anyone who's been aroused by the spirit of death and hell, you shall be set free in the name of Jesus. You shall be set free, you shall be set free, you shall be set free. You shall be set free, you shall be set free in the name of Jesus. Rise up on your feet now. All eyes closed. In case you are here today, say, man of God, I want to surrender my life to Jesus. I too want to bind the spirit of death and hell. I do not want the enemy to waste my life. Wherever you are, while all eyes are closed, find a way to the altar here, or to any of the altars at the back. Jesus is waiting for you here.
Yes,
those of you at the altars, I congratulate you. Taking the most important decision in life. Just bow down your heads and say what I'm going to say now after
that.
Say, Father,
Baba,
in the name of Jesus,
Jesus,
I come before you now. I know that you care for me. Lord Jesus, come into my life. Take control of my life. As from today, I say bye to the devil. I enter into the kingdom of Christ. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Father, I thank you for your children. You've taken the most important decision in life. Father, keep them standing by your power. Lay your hands upon them. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name we pray.
Okay.
I want you to pray these prayers. Don't joke with these prayers. And don't negotiate with the enemy. This is not a day to negotiate. This is a day to fight a good warfare. Thank you, Jesus. Can you say this loud and clear? Say, every power calling my name from the grave, can you say this loud and clear? Is that the loudest you can call it?
Last right.
We got there.
Make today a very special day in your life. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you,
Jesus.
In Jesus' name we pray. If you have any sickness in your body, this is the time to deal with them. Arrows of infirmity.
Fire
against me.
Do you want to see me?
Can you say this loud and clear? Shout it loud and clear. Then begin to deal with it.
There is any property.
Maseka ponda kaya boshe mera bofula kaya bosanta. Command the arrows of infirmity to
backfire.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray.
Glory to Jesus. There
are seven persons here. There was a time an evil wind blew against you. And as a result of that evil wind, you have been having afflictions. Right there where you are, the power of God is coming upon you now. And that affliction is broken to pieces. In the name of Jesus. That's the first person. That's number two. That's number three. That's number four. That's number five. Number six. And that's number seven. That's right. Thank you, Jesus. Father, I pray right now that all your children who are gathered here today, any challenge that the power of the graveyard is bringing against you, I silence it now. In the name of Jesus, any power that is meditating against your life, any power assigned to kill your career, to kill your marriage, to kill your children, to kill your progress, let those powers be destroyed in the name of Jesus. It is written, you shall not die but live to declare the words of God. Every power that wants to put you to shame in the land of the living, let them be disgraced in the name of Jesus. Right there where you are, begin to possess your possession. Possess your possession. Possess your possession. Possess your possession. In the name of Jesus. Right there where you are, anything the enemy has planted into any arena of your life, whether you are conscious of it or you are not conscious of it, it is written that the strangers shall fade away and they shall be afraid out of their close places. Every stranger in the body, use your hold in the name of Jesus. Use your hole in the name of Jesus. Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Now say this loud and clear.
This is a weaver in love, brother.
Any evil connection. With any dead person. Break. In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and begin to declare that what you. Break it. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Break it in the name of Jesus. He said that, Lord, let them measure my case here today so that I too can be blessed. The Lord said I should tell you that within the next 48 hours you shall have mighty testimonies. Thank you, Jesus. 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 You will now say this loud and clear.
Oh, are we by no other
voices from the grave?
Hello, that is a good
sign against my life. Your time is up. Can I hear you say this loud and clear? Make it loud and loud. Death in the name of Jesus. Jesus' name we pray. Now begin to speak all the blessings that you can remember, the blessings that is coming out of your spirit, man. Speak it into your mind now. Speak it into your mind, man. Bless yourself. Blessings of God. Bless yourself, bless yourself. Amen.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah.
Okay, hallelujah.
Another hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Don't read it.
All our prayer requests now.
Father,
we thank you for this prayer letters.
Answer
by fire in the name of Jesus. I prophesy upon your life
that
by the time you come here, that for the next man must change. You will be a bigger bundle of testimonies. Every force of oppression, no matter what name Scatter now in the name of Jesus. It is written that you that heals the
disabled,
then comes your hand. Then comes from the Lord,
you may
never suffer. Do not suffer for you to be moved. But I keep it to your last number. I keep it to your generous number of sleep. The Lord shall keep you in all your coming out. The Lord shall keep you in all your ways. No evil shall befall you. Never shall any plague on earth. And they shall be well with you. In Jesus' name we pray. And as you are the best of fellowship.